Hey, good evening, everybody. This is Sportsnet News. I'm Joe Bork, and it was not a good evening yet again for our Reading Royals as the recent struggles continue. As now they have a 4-1 loss to add, or a 4-2 loss, excuse me, to add to the skid tonight against the Newfoundland Growlers. As Bykov stays hot, only having really one bad game in this run himself, in the 9-1 loss that nobody looked good, and even in that 5-1, he still looks solid in. But he stays hot, getting two goals, where Lynch, Zach O'Brien, Pelton Bice, and then Skeever were the ones that were, or Skirving, excuse me, were the ones that were able to score for the Newfoundland Growlers, the division leader. The Royals did not take advantage this game of being able to take two out of three. Now it's going to be much harder because you don't win the front game, which gives you an opportunity to obviously lose the next two. So it's going to be much harder with how this team's playing. Like they said on the broadcast, just Frank, the Royals have been getting pounded lately. They use some other adjective in there, but they've been getting destroyed lately in games, minus that last game against the Trois-Rivières Lions, where they actually probably deserved to win it. Hopefully, it doesn't take till then against the Newfoundland Growlers. It would be nice to obviously get a point out of them in the last game. I wouldn't complain about that, but you need to do more and you need to get more points. And the Reading Royals, they were able to get the wraparound goal by Pritchard that was then a beautiful backhander over Cormier after he tried to wrap it around and score. Cormier made a nice save, who, by the way, now has he had coming into this game 10 games, 9 wins. Now he has 11 games, 10 wins. That dude absolutely was killing it, or is killing it, I should say, for the Norfolk at, or the Newfoundland Growlers. And then when it comes to Bobby Lynch, that was just a really weird play. He was able to bank it off of low and get a goal when the puck went off of the boards, came back up front. Lynch was able to bank it off of low. Just a very unfortunate play. Zach O'Brien was then able to score on the breakaway for his 22nd point on the season, which we thought initially was shorthanded because it was a weird no call where DeChara got tripped on the other end. 100% should have been a call. Then they put the face off in the offensive zone, but didn't have a penalty call, so it was a really weird turn of events and really weird play there. But he was able to score on a breakaway that ended up being at even strength. Pat Nagel was definitely an MVP of this game through two and really in the entire game. None of the goals were his fault, including the Skirving deflection at the end where they were able to tightrope the line and then get his goal. And then Pelton Bice's goal was when he was able to steal it from Bykov, where originally I thought that was Cressy with the watching it on Flow TV, but it was Bykov that turned it over while going back and skating up, trying to make a move. Not a good look there as he turns it over in the wrong spot to turn over neutral zone. Pelton Bice goes on the break and is able to score on Pat Nagel, who played a very good game tonight, even in giving up four. Just because you give up four goals, like I've said in past videos, doesn't mean you played a bad game. It could just mean your team, as the Royals did, getting outshot 31 to 22. They only outshot them 11 to 6 in the third, but I still thought the Growlers pushed pretty well in the third period, and the Royals could have got more. They got the one goal by Pritchard, obviously, on the one power play there, which was nice to see, but you could have got more there to be able to kind of battle more back into it here. You got to get more consistent on the offensive zone. You got to play better in front of your goaltender. The Royals, obviously, other than one game in their last four, have not looked good and have got smoked in the games. You obviously have to try to rebound from this. Early in the season, the Royals were winning, and then the only lull times are when, like Kirk McDonald talked about when I said in past videos while covering the team while at home at Santander Arena, they just have really bad lull periods. Well, now they're having lull periods in multiple games for most of the game, and that's really when it becomes damning and a huge problem. So you need to rebound from this. You need to get something going. Whatever gets it going, you just need to figure it out going forward. And obviously, our Royals, again, just like they had against the Trois-Rivières Lions last week, are not going to have long to look ahead as they play the same Newfoundland team again at 5:30 on Friday, and then again at 5:30 on Saturday. So I will be doing a preview to that game on Friday, just like I did for this game. I hope you all have a great, safe, and pleasant night. And hopefully it starts going better for our Royals in the future. It's been a struggle due to injuries, but that's no excuse, just an observation due to injuries with the entire organization thus far. But Nagel played a hell of a game again. Pritchard played a hell of a game again. DeChara also had very nice plays. Should have got called for a penalty. I was looking good out there. And I thought Roth was the guy that was able to get that one. I'm not sure if it was actually the case, but I thought he was the guy that was able to get that one breakaway that was kind of hard to see because of the angles they have on flow hockey. But I did think that he was the guy that was able to get that one break in his first game. So that was nice to see for him, who also had two shots on the night. So that's nice to see for him get two shots on that. And I believe one was number 23 on that breakaway. It was tough to see from an angle, but that's nice to see in his first game him come out, have a solid, effective game. Just like we've seen other forwards like Cam Strong come in, play a pretty solid, effective game. Obviously, this entire season, but as a rookie, when he first came in, had a good first game, and then just kept building from that. So everybody have a great, safe, and pleasant day. Stay safe out there. A special thanks to the 170 that have subbed already. If you enjoy the content and have not, please consider subscribing down below on the sub button or on the easy-to-use widget up above, as well as over at Flyers Nitty Gritty for great Flyers organization coverage and Delaware Thunder coverage. Peace out, everybody.